Hey, welcome back to part 5 of my Clockwork Empire's Amateur's Guide. What did I call it? Amateur's Guide to Basic Functionality? Whatever. It's me blathering on about Clockwork Empires. So by now I think we've demonstrated most of the basic systems in the game. And we said last time that we had 3 long-term goals. Make pie, make booze, which we've done. The only one remaining is to make guns. But before I get to that, I am going to deal with this wave of immigrants. I think we could use an overseer now. Probably skim off enough workers from other work crews to populate another work crew. I see there's cult stuff happening in the background. I'll have to deal with that later. So, weapons are manufactured at an arsenal. Now, an arsenal is fairly simple to build. It doesn't require too many resources, but the things you build in an arsenal require all manner of, like, finished metal products. So they're fairly involved, but of course, having things like guns and landmines are quite important to the survival of your colony. I'm going to build ye olde arsenal right over here. Let's give it a funny shape. Boop. Boop. See if we can freak out the building generator. Right. Rolling cargo door. I'm not sure the exact function of rolling cargo doors. I mean, I really like their animation, and I think they add to the game. Maybe settlers don't like block each other in rolling doors the same way they do in conventional doors. Who knows? But I like having them, even if they're just for aesthetic reasons. Okay, here we go. All modules in place. Let's get to building. So the smithing forge, which we have 2, requires an iron sheet and 3 bricks. So we're not going to have enough bricks to build 2 smithing forges. So we need to make more bricks. So now we look to our ceramics workshop here, which can turn clay blocks into bricks. Or sorry, cubes of clay into bricks. We've got a ton of cubes of clay. Queue up some bricks. So the superstructure for the arsenal is complete. I lie, it is not complete. That notification was to tell me that I have no work crews assigned to the ceramics workshop. Must be at least 1 crew assigned there so that bricks are made. Somebody's happy, and these 2 are talking about cults. These 3 are talking about foul and pestilent architecture. How are we doing for cooking? Well, I believe pie is actively being cooked. I think. The ovens seem to be going full blast, even though there is no cooking going on. What are you doing? You are hauling... Oh, that's beer. Alright, now the arsenal superstructure has been completed. Ah, look at that roof. Oh, somebody has been frontier what's going on here? Looks like she was hauling booze and was interrupted by a fishman and chased to the edges of the world. And who is this? Oh god, it's Muriel Ribbitsley. I believe she's the overseer of Mrs. Ribbitsley's temperate presses. There's a high probability she's going to die out here, which means one of my work crews is not going to have an overseer and won't be able to complete workshop jobs, and I'm going to have to reorganize the entire colony. Also, I see one of my colonists went on a murder spree and was summarily executed by my soldiers. And, what's going on? Why are my soldiers shooting at this lady? Oh, his job is frontier justice. I assume she also attempted a murder spree. She's now the late Lucinda Riverhook, but she's dead. Now she's just an upright zombie. Well, I think we've encountered another bug. Okay. See the state of our work crews here. So these two are without a work crew because their overseer died. It might have been Lucinda Rivethook or it might have been that other lady. I'm gonna stick them over here. Yeah, that's the ticket. So, I believe... Well, let's see. We're good on food, good on guns. I'm going to take materials. That'll help us build weapons. Arsenal is still waiting on materials to be delivered. Brick making is... Muriel Ribbitsley has died. I think we've encountered a bug where dead colonists no longer fall over dead. And she was an overseer. I have yet another squad without... I've yet another squad without an overseer. I've got to reorganize again. This is becoming a problem. At this point, I've got plenty of workers, but I sorely need more overseers. Right. I think I saw that Rivetsley was the overseer for the Boozatorium. Oh look, they made their entire order of beer and they've started making whiskey. Now I've only got one currently unassigned work crew, so the new one. So Mr. Willock is now the overseer of the brewery. Making bricks, so we should soon have enough materials to make our smithing forges. Oh god. So this is what, well, in a way this is a good thing. This is what I was hoping to show you. If cultist activity goes too far, one of them will go an Eldritch Transformation. In this case, Cordelia Iron Orscotter, a cultist, has undergone an Eldritch Transformation and turned into this thing, the horrifying Obeleskian. I believe it may actually be called the... in game files, it may be referred to as the Obeleskian Servitor. Basically, it's a nigh-indestructible floating stone block, an eldritch horror, or a servant of eldritch horrors beyond time and space. This is only the first hint of things to come. I'm fortunate in that it doesn't seem to be attacking my town. And the brave soldiers of the Empire have put down the unnameable horror. What are you doing? Oh. As we've observed, Obeleskian servitors can apparently be butchered for stone blocks. Well, you know what they say, waste not, want not. Ah, more unassigned colonists? What? Was she also? She was also an overseer. Oh my goodness. Alright, that's three work crews I've lost in the last couple of minutes. I'm going to start having administrative problems here. I only have two non-military crews now. I'm going to severely crimp my ability to run multiple jobs simultaneously. Well, let's see. Farming, bury corpses. I'm going to expand our storage a little bit. No food in this stockpile. And this is a food-only stockpile. Now, normally the victims of the Eldritch Transformation float around town, beating up colonists with their tentacles. This is particularly unhelpful when, like, multiple bad things all happen together or they cascade into each other. So colonists who witness the Eldritch Transformation are upset. Right? It makes them angry, it makes them less effective colonists, that makes them more susceptible to fighting poorly. Things like seeing fishmen or being attacked by fishmen will also affect morale. And then axe murderers, cultists. So all of those things can trigger each other, which means sometimes you can get this horrible, like, sequence or cascade of terrible things that all happen one after the other or simultaneously. Now, I'm going to take an overseer here. We've got plenty of workers, but not enough overseers. Mr. Steelflood, you are exactly what we needed. I'm going to skim a worker off of here and here. And here, and actually we'll take two out of here. Alright, looks like our arsenal is complete. I'd like to make a gun. Let's make five guns, actually. Not that we need them. I think we've got so few soldiers left, we have more than enough guns for each of them. But we can take a look at what the arsenal can produce. Gunpowder, ammunition, landmines, and then a variety of guns. Ammunition needs gunpowder, as do landmines. Let's make some muskets. Now, muskets need buckets of cogs. We've queued up five, and we have five cogs. We have enough iron ingots, and we have enough planks. So we should be able to complete the muskets, no problem. The distillery does indeed have a crew. Now the kitchen seems to be stuck. Maybe this will fix it. I'm going to cancel these, and I'm going to queue up some more cabbage stew. Yeah, that should do it. Now we've got no work crew assigned to making bricks, but that's okay. We don't need any more bricks. We don't need anything smelted. So if necessary, we can take work crews that are assigned to one workshop and assign them to a different workshop instead. If at some point we desperately need those bricks, we can take them away from the boozatorium, for instance. I call it the boozatorium, but you guys know I'm talking about the brewery, right? Get the feeling we will soon be requiring more space in the graveyard. I haven't talked about Malfeasant Clawbulb. Now, you can see these... Oh, I'll get back to that. What the heck just happened here? Why? How did this happen? Oh god. Nine fish people incoming, and colonists are dropping like flies. Got a military strength of 6. Alright, Mr. Willock. Your squad has been conscripted. Ah, Rooster Will. Who the heck is this? What are my colonists doing here? I don't remember sending them way the heck out here. What is going on? What are you guys doing? Returning goods? What goods? A dagger and beer? Why is there beer out here? I'm so confused and... Oh no. Destroying my gabions. I just lost another overseer. Stamping on my crops. Ooh. I have no NCOs. But this is very neat. A colonial minister has sent you a new NCO. This is great. So I can take one and take an NCO, which I sorely need. I will lose prestige, or I can refuse and not lose prestige, but I, you know, I'm in the middle of a fishman attack, no one organizing my soldiers. A new officer should arrive within a day. Well, that can't happen soon enough. I'll pause for a second. So I've got a soldier here without an NCO. Just put them in here for now. Oh, this lady is out of bullets. And someone else has just been beaten to death. Oh well, we knew about him. Fishmen are making a mess out of my colony. My colonists are fleeing into the wilderness. Oh, I see. This man has no gun. Even better. I think we got a little too cocky. I should probably have been working on my military strength or maybe shoring up my defenses. Ah, I was blinded by my initial success. Crops were good, food production was good. We were able to easily handle the initial waves of fishmen. Oh dear. Another oh dear. Smuggly Boffin has died. Looks like he was an overseer. Someone else was beaten to death. And I've lost another overseer. Things are looking grim for new Antipodia. Oh my gosh, look at all those unassigned work crews. Oh, here's my new military NCO though. What I need now, more than production capacity, is the ability to defend the colony. Well, I may have been jinxing myself when I said we'll soon be able to make use of this extra graveyard space. But at least now there's room for their corpses. Looks like the attack is tailing off. If you see these craters in the ground, it means a fishman has stepped on a mine. Another attack? Well, this one's only three. Supplies. Oh, I think I'll take guns this time. And yet more colonists dead. Well, at this point, I think we've fulfilled all our long-term goals. We successfully built 5 muskets, a pie, and booze, both beer and whiskey. I think I've been able to demonstrate all of the fundamental systems. Now this game is in pre-release, early access on Steam. The devs are very active on the forums and in the various threads. They're very diligent about squashing bugs. and they work, they update like madmen. So I'm quite pleased with the pace and direction of the game thus far. I'm looking forward to more content. But I think that about wraps up my my series. So I hope you've enjoyed watching it. My name is Alfred. You can find me under that name or a minor variation thereof on the Gaslamp Games official forums, where I try to be helpful. And Clockwork Empires also has an official wiki. It's a Gamepedia curse wiki, not hard to find. If you're looking for more information, you can go there. I hope you've enjoyed watching the series. I might consider doing some sort of playthrough at some future point. Oh, look at those deaths racking up. There is another biome, which I think would be interesting for people to see. There's actually a jungle biome. It's a misty jungle with palm trees and coconuts and different kinds of crops and different kinds of animals you can harvest from meat. It changes the dynamic of the game as well, because there are more fishmen in the swampy marshes of the jungle. Well, New Antipodia, for a moment, you are a glowing beacon of the, a glowing beacon of the Empire. And we're going to have to leave you here. Godspeed and good luck.